31st of October 2011, the Earth's population is projected to reach 7 billion. This global milestone presents opportunities and challenges, and I caught up with Babatunde Osotimehin, who is Executive Director of the United Nations Population Fund, to discuss the issues around population growth.
On the 31st of October, we will get to the 7 billion mark. We at UNFPA are bringing this to the consciousness of the global community as an opportunity and a call to action. Of course, there are challenges, and there are challenges because population is a tapestry. It's not about growth alone. It's about decline in some places, growth in some places. There's urbanization. There are issues of youth. So there are many things within that tapestry that we need to address. So we're hoping that this momentum that we're trying to create would actually give the world an opportunity to begin to address these issues one by one.
Of course, I ask because it's in a context where inequalities persist. So how do you see this kind of growth impacting our ability to close that divide between rich and poor?
I think that going forward, what we see in most nation states and most countries today is that there is considerable, there is a build-up to transparency and accountability, and we're beginning to see better governance in many parts of the world. And I believe that that is going to improve the issue of equity. And I think that, what we know today about population and what we know about resources, we need to do a better job, ensuring that there's equity and social justice in the system.
Nearly all of that growth, 97 of every 100 people, is occurring in less developed countries. This is sure to have an impact on future economic development. Are policy and funding decisions needed to support this growth happening fast enough and in tandem?
They might not be happening fast enough, but I think they're happening. And we have focal points in the developing country where actually governments are taking the right decisions and movement is going in the right direction. We at UNFPA and our other sister UN agencies are actually engaging with governments to ensure that they do the following things. One, empower women to make choices, educate them very well. Make sure that the young girl goes to school and stays in school, and give them age-appropriate sexuality education. Ensure that they also are able to access health services, particularly reproductive health services and family planning, so they can plan their families, they can decide when to have children, how many children they want to have, and what spacing they are going to have, and how many they can afford, because I think that is a major issue there. And one byproduct of it, which obviously is of interest to the world, is that in places of the world where women have been empowered to participate as equal partners in the economy of their countries, progress has happened in terms of the growth of the economies.
Policy aside, urbanization is something that stands in the foreground, especially in developing economies. Are we seeing effective enough measures being put in place and planning taking place to support growth like this?
I want to believe that going forward, that is one growth area which we need to put a lot of attention. Urbanization is not just a developing country phenomenon. Urbanization is a global phenomenon. And we reckon that by the year 2050, 70% of the world would actually be living in urban areas. So we need to begin to design cities better, to design the lives of people so that it can have quality, to ensure that we don't end up with urban slums, to ensure that there is education, there is access to health, and that young people have a role to play in all of that. And I think that we will make a better place of the world if we do that.
Well, on the one hand, we're looking at aging populations. On the other, young people forging the future. Take us through the kind of dynamic that presents itself right now.
There are two bookmarks in terms of population dynamics today. The first is the first that I described earlier on, the developing countries' situation where growth is happening very rapidly. In those countries, we actually have very youthful population. What you end up with there is that 60 to 70% of those countries are young people. And I want to say that the best way to engage with those young people is to give them space so that economically, politically, they can participate in the growth of their country. Now, on the other hand, are countries where, you know, actually population is shrinking. And in those circumstances, you actually have an aging population. And the aging population is what is going to also affect the labor and the social welfare there. And we need to begin to put in place social policies to address the various things that will happen there. Pension schemes, health schemes, housing schemes that would be appropriate to an aged population and would also provide dignity for people who have spent their lives building their countries.
Of course, unemployment is a big theme in the global economy right now, especially amongst the youth, where economic growth isn't filtering through. So just how much of a challenge does this pace of population growth present for that unemployment picture moving forward?
Unemployment is becoming a global problem, and I think that is also part of what we see in the global fiscal space in terms of, you know, the fragility of the banking system, of the fiscal system. But I want to believe that going forward, what needs to happen is a new paradigm that seeks to create new jobs, different from what we have now. For an example, the world is looking at sustainable development, and we have these young people, say, in the developing world, who are looking to be engaged. Why don't we try to find ways and means of providing them opportunities to be entrepreneurs of the green economy? So they will be the ones to be moving this agenda. It's a win-win situation for everybody. They'll get jobs, and the world will be a better place for all of us to live in.